the arena. My name is Michael Chalfan, and with my colleagues is Jake Daniels, Kameron Mack, and Dominique Postell. We're going to jump right into free agency this year. As everybody knows, this has probably been one of the craziest free agencies that we have seen in recent memory in the NFL. So we're going to start off in the NFC. Jake, what's your outlook on the Eagles' move so far? And let's not forget about the injury prone quarterback they just picked up at Sam Bradford. He's been out the last 2 seasons with an ACL injury.
And now he's supposed to be your starter. So now
and then you have Sanchez and then Tim Tebow working out. How does that even work, Cal?
I don't really know, but like, I mean, it's really just confusing. All these moves are really confusing because you say that you want to move McCoy to save money, but then you spend $17 million all on running backs. Like, that's the highest in the league so far. So it's kind of like you're trying to save money, but you're going to bring in two running backs and injury problems. Like that. I really don't like these moves.
They should have went ahead and start looking for a nice backup quarterback, if anything, and then get some running. You could have went to the draft and got younger running backs. You got Darren Sproles as your backup. I'm not saying he's not a bad running back. He's getting older. You have other people that's playing for them that are getting older, and then you don't have any just the best receivers on the field, and you could go pick up, you could go pick up somebody out of the draft that can be great for you and young, you know what I'm saying?
I really got scared of Riley Cooper.
Yeah,
these are not big threats.
I mean, 2 years ago, y'all got rid of, DeSean Jackson, and that was y'all's best threat, and then you get rid of him.
And then he goes to the Redskins. What's with everybody in the NFC going to each other's rivals? Like, I don't understand, especially the Redskins and the Giants. They have known to be taking other teams.
I want to say, out of y'all just being Cowboys fans, I really don't think y'all have made that big a move besides DeMarco Murray. I think y'all might have made some good moves, like, picking up McFadden, that could be something just to get in where he fits in. But I really think y'all should be, y'all should start looking for a backup quarterback that might take over. Because Tony Romo doesn't have that.
I have been saying that for the longest. I would not mind trying to get a third-round quarterback in the draft and just have him sit under the
Well, how would happen?
We tried this before. We tried this with Stephen McGee from A&M, and he just never panned out. I liked him when he came out, but I'm guessing the coaching staff didn't see anything in him.
Yeah.
They released him. He was a third-round draft pick.
Yeah.
And it seems that, I don't know whether it is with the Cowboys, whenever there's a star, whoever's behind them does not pan out. Martellus Bennett, another one, with Jason Witten, did not pan out. He's a great guy now, but
at the same time, he was kind of behind Jason Witten, so it was kind of hard for him to just find that spot. You know what I mean? So,
but then there's a lot of times that he dropped. He had a lot of big passes. I think what is going to happen is the Cowboys will be right back where they were. They're going to go out and get a young running back. But let's not forget, they're going to get better on defense. They're going to go out and draft defensive players once again. And then you have the system now where they come in and they tell them, look, you do not need to be a superstar. You do your job. And it worked pretty well for the Cowboys. Yeah, Sean Lee's coming back. We did lost Rolando McClain and Bruce Carter.
Well, we still might get Rolando McClain, but Bruce Carter and Justin Durant are for sure gone.
Yeah.
I think Durant went to the Falcons.
Yeah, and then Bruce Carter went to the Bucks.
Yeah.
But it's still the fact that they're going to get better on defense.
Exactly.
And that's all it really boils down to, because I'm not going to sit there and say you're going to have the same productivity that DeMarco Murray had on that line, but you're going to have a 1,000-yard back behind that line. And it doesn't matter who it is.
And would you think it matter even if, like, say, if one running back have 800 and another one have 800?
No, not at all.
I mean, because
that's even better for us because there's fresh legs.
Exactly. And if we still – if the thing is, we still have the one main card. We still have Dez Bryant. And once we have Dez Bryant, that's our main star right there.
It doesn't matter, because what happens if Tony Romo gets hurt because you know he has back problems.
Right, exactly. Who's going to throw it? Well, no, what I'm saying is, we're still going to have a running game. I'm still confident in the running
game.
That's not going to win. But at the same time, we still have the Dez Bryant, which other teams don't have.
Speaking of Dez Bryant, when do you think a deal's going to get done?
I think it's going to happen before the summer.
I think they're trying to let everything smooth out with whatever situation is going on. Just let all his drama, whatever's going on with him, pan out. And then, you know, hopefully, you know, the Cowboys could go get Matt Schaub since he ain't playing for the Raiders no more.
You see our face right now? We don't find that funny at all.
I find it funny because he's...
Well, it's better than having who y'all have right now as the Texans.
Mullet, we got Brian Hoyer. You know, we picked up Brian Hoyer.
That's so much better.
We're talking about the
NFC, but let's go on to another quarterback in the NFC. RG3, what's his future?
Wow, no. Really?
He's not going, hey.
I don't know.
Like Jake said earlier, RG knee. That's the
RG knee.
I'm saying that for you.
Hey. Do you honestly think you just said it. They haven't, except for that first season, they have not done anything constantly to try to help him out around. They've just been letting him just go to waste. He's on the run.
Exactly.
He's on the run or he's on the side.
All right, Cameron, do you see him going back to the Redskins next year?
I can see him go back, but it's just the main question is, what are they going to pay him?
I mean, that's true. I mean, it's true because, I mean, he's still, what is this, his last year of the contract, I believe?
Yeah,
but at the same time, I'm really thinking that he's low-key a coach killer. Because if you think about it, Mike Shanahan, that it really didn't work out. Last year, they was talking about, RG3 or Jay Gruden. So it's kind of like, I really don't know if he's going to, like, are you going to choose the quarterback, which is really not doing nothing, I mean, for the team, or Jay Gruden, who's...
I think he should start just looking for future plans.
They just re-signed Colt McCoy today.
Yeah, that told him everything he said.
I don't see no activity going for Kirk Cousins because I know Kirk Cousins wanted to get traded, but
right.
He wants
to start, but I think.
But I mean, last year he kind of had a port, but at the same time, they didn't have.